Welcome to our Introduction to Machine Learning course. I'm Josh Blumenstock.
My name is Dan Gillick. So quickly, a little bit about me. Currently, I work at Google in research, and my specialty is natural language processing. Before Google, I got a PhD from UC Berkeley in computer science. And before that, actually, when I was an undergrad, my majors were computer science and English literature, and I think this unusual combination gave rise to my current interest. So at Google, my group works on building tools that other teams around the company can use to understand automatically the syntax and semantics inherent in both queries and in documents.
Great. And as I said, my name is Joshua Blumenstock. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Washington Information School. There I teach courses on machine learning and data science. And I actually know Dan from undergrad and grad school. We did both together. I did my undergrad in computer science and physics. From there, I spent some time working in bioinformatics and a little bit in startup companies in the Bay Area before going back to grad school, where I studied economics and eventually got my PhD at the Information School at UC Berkeley. And the sort of work I do now is really at the intersection of economics and computer science. Specifically, I focus on applications of machine learning and, you know, quote unquote, big data in developing countries and other resource-constrained environments. A lot of the focus I do is trying to help policymakers and foundations, people like the Gates Foundation or the UN, come to grips and better understand how big data and new sources of data can be useful when they're designing policy for these environments.
Okay, so just briefly, let me give you a quick overview of what is machine learning. And so from the point of view of this class, we're going to talk about sort of two general kinds of machine learning. The first is the supervised setting. In the supervised setting, you've got some input and some output. And all you want to do is try to predict the output from the input. And the assumption is that in some way you've accumulated a lot of labeled examples, where an example is a piece of input and the accompanying correct label. And we'll talk about where such data might come from. And then the goal is to train a model that can do that prediction automatically. In the unsupervised setting, the data sort of looks the same, except that now we have no specific labels. And instead of trying to predict something in particular, unsupervised learning has more to do with understanding the patterns inherent in the data, sort of what kind of clusters emerge from this data that are latent that you might not otherwise have been able to detect.
Right. And you'll see in the course, the focus is really heavily balanced towards supervised learning. We probably spend the first 8 or 9 weeks talking about supervised learning. And this is really just because it reflects the focus of the field. And then spend a few weeks talking about unsupervised learning. I mean, again, which is more designed to detect the underlying structure in the data. And a couple weeks tacked on at the end about network models and network machine learning. But it's worth saying up front that the goal of this class is really to give you all a practical understanding of how machine learning is used and to familiarize you with a bunch of the different algorithms out there. As opposed to some courses on machine learning that focus much more on the mathematical formalisms and the nitty-gritty details of implementation, what we really want you to come out of this understanding is how you would go out and use these algorithms in a real data environment. So if you have a supervised problem, what sort of algorithms would work better than others? And you know, from time to time, we'll ask you to implement these, but really the focus is more on a high-level understanding.